If you're brand new in real estate, or if you're just looking for something to get some serious momentum going in your business, this is gonna be the video for you. What's up, everybody? Ricky Carruth here. Welcome back to my channel. So the title of this video is Why You Should Do Your First Real Estate Deal For Free. And I know a lot of you are probably thinking, why in the world would I do a real estate deal for absolutely free? And I'll tell you right now, this is something that I wish I would have known from day one in real estate 17 years ago. I would be so much further ahead in my career right now if I understood the principles that I'm gonna talk about in this video. It took me 8 long months to make my first sale. I would have made my first sale a lot sooner if I would have known what I'm fixing to tell you. So first I wanna tell you why you should do your first deal for free, and then I'm gonna tell you how you should do your first deal for free. And before I get into those two points, I wanna let you know that this Thursday, right here on this YouTube channel, I'm gonna go live and I'm gonna call prospects and I'm gonna tell them that I wanna help them sell their properties for absolutely free. This is something that nobody has ever done in the industry, and I'm gonna go live Thursday and I'm gonna do it right in front of the entire world. So if you aren't subscribed, click subscribe, hit the bell so you can get notified when I go live, and also sign up for my absolutely free coaching program. I'm the very first absolutely completely 100% free real estate coach in the world, and that is at zerotodiamond.com. And as always, reach out if you need anything in the world. You can reach me on Instagram, email, comment below this video. I answer every single engagement. So if there's anything you need, reach out to me. So let's get into why you need to sell your first property for absolutely free, okay? The entire Zero to Diamond philosophy, the main philosophy, our tagline is relationships over transactions. Okay, in the very first half of my career, I did real estate completely backwards from the way that it should be done. Everything for me was about the transaction, the money, the closing, the deal. It wasn't about the people. And it took me having to lose everything in the crash and going bankrupt and homeless for a brief moment of my life to realize what I had done wrong and how I needed to rebuild my business based on relationships, not transactions. So when I got back in the business, I started creating and maintaining lifelong relationships with my clients. I didn't care if they bought or sold anything. I just wanted to help them for the rest of my life. Anytime they wanted to buy or sell something, or if they knew anybody that wanted to buy or sell anything. I quickly learned that every prospect that I do this with is worth 10 to 20 deals to me over the life of my career, regardless if they do anything the day or the month or even the year that I talk to them for the first time. A lot of trainers, a lot of coaches will tell you if they're not motivated, move on. To me, that's absolutely the wrong advice. Most of my business nowadays, and the reason why I'm able to sell 100 properties a year for the last 5 years straight, is through the exact process that I'm telling you, creating and maintaining lifelong relationships with so many property owners, so many potential buyers in my market. You cannot worry if they're gonna do a deal with you or not. And a lot of agents come to me and they ask me, how do I convert? When I go to a listing appointment, how do I get them to sign the listing agreement? And my answer is, you don't. Your job is not to convert them. Your job is not to make them sign that listing agreement. There's nothing you're gonna magically say that's gonna make them sign the line or do the deal. They already know when they wanna do the deal. They need an agent they feel comfortable with that makes them feel like a friend or family member. I call it the FE effect. They need somebody that's gonna represent them the way that they wanna be represented and not try to high pressure them into a situation just because the agent wants to make some money. The number one skill in real estate is not how to get somebody to sign the line or knowing how to handle objections or any of that stuff. The number one skill is learning how to effectively communicate who you are as a person to your clients. That you care, that you're hardworking, that you're dependable, that you're professional, that you're knowledgeable, that you're gonna go over the top to help them through whatever the situation is they're trying to get through and make sure everything goes smooth for them. So the reason that you should do your first real estate deal for free, or if you're plateauing in your business, say you're 3 or 4 years in and you just can't get any momentum going, you don't really know how to get it going again, you need to do a real estate deal for free. You need to go after a prospect and help them for absolutely nothing. Okay, what happens is you begin this relationship with this prospect and they will never ever use another agent ever in their life, ever again. And they're gonna refer everybody they know to you. I've been thinking about this for several weeks and I've been contemplating and I've been trying to figure out what the strategy should be on this. And my strategy is with for sale by owners, right? You can't take an owner and say, I'm gonna list your property for free. You can't put it on MLS in your name for zero commission. Your broker would not agree with that. That's just not how it's going to work. But you can go to a for sale by owner and you can consult them. You can help them. You can teach them how to put it on MLS theirself. You can show them how to make better remarks, get professional pictures, advise them on the price. Okay, you can do all the things and teach them all the little secrets about how to sell it on their own. And don't be the gatekeeper of MLS. Show them how to put it on MLS. A lot of agents want to hold that part back and be the gatekeeper, and so that the for sale by owner thinks that they have to have an agent to put it on MLS. Not true. Okay, so the strategy is very simple. We're going to advise them. We're going to put them in the best position. We're not going to hold back anything. We're going to tell them every little thing that we know that will help them get that property sold. Maybe some staging, maybe some painting, maybe some repairs. We're going to give them everything we can possibly do to help them sell that property. And to take it a step further, I would even make phone calls. Make phone calls to property owners who you think might could upgrade to the property that's for sale. Okay, so a lot of things happen here. What happens is, as far as the for sale by owner is concerned, you went over the top to try to help them get their property sold. What if they don't sell it and they get ready to list it? They're tired of all the showings. They're tired of dealing with all the buyers. They're tired of dealing with people who say they're going to do stuff and show up at different times or don't follow through with offers. They're just tired of it and they're ready to just give it to an agent. What agent? Who do you think they're going to list with? They're going to list with you because you were there trying to help them for zero commissions. Okay, let's think about the flip side. Let's think about if they do get it sold themselves through your advice. Okay, now they're ready to buy. Who do you think they're gonna buy through? You, the one who was helping them for zero commissions. And when they buy, they don't pay a commission at all. So they're a lot more apt to deal with an agent in the buying process, somebody that's gonna represent them, somebody's gonna look out for them and their best interest than they are when they're trying to sell a property. In a couple weeks, a couple months, a couple years, their cousin, brother, mother, daughter wants to buy a house or sell a house. Who do you think they're gonna refer that person to? You. Okay, let's say you took the rest of my advice and you started making phone calls to try to sell that property. Let's talk about the magic that happens there. When you're talking to these property owners who might want to upgrade to the for sale by owner, okay, you're going to run into all kinds of people and have all kinds of incredible conversations. You're going to create so many future relationships. There may be some people in that batch of phone calls that want to do business now. They don't want the for sale by owner. They want something else that's listed. Or they want to sell their house. They're looking for an agent. They're thinking about doing this or that. This is how you get business going. You stir the pot. You talk to people. You get on the phone. You create activity. Okay? You take massive action. Okay, let's run through it again. We're gonna call for sale by owners. We're gonna help them. We're gonna let them know. We want to consult them and try to sell their property. We don't want anything out of it. We just want them to get that property sold. That's all we're there for. So we're gonna consult them. We're gonna help them get it on MLS on their own. We're gonna look at the remarks, the price, the pictures. Make sure they're professional pictures. We're gonna see if there's anything they might want to do to the house to try to make it more appealing to buyers. Then we might actually make phone calls. Okay, well, now with phone calls, that's dual purpose. I like to have dual purpose with everything I do. Okay, the purpose of the phone calls is to maybe help that for sale owner sell their house so that they can buy something from you. And at the same time, you may run into more future clients. Okay, so there's dual purpose there. It's not just one objective. Everything I do has more than one objective. Okay, let's run through the different scenarios of the different results that could happen. Okay, the seller of the for sale by owner could sell it on their own and buy something from you. Great. They could go ahead and list it with you because they're tired of trying to sell it on their own. Great. Out of the phone calls, you could run into all kinds of clients that want to do business now or later. Great. Let's say that the for sale by owner sells it on their own and buys on their own or buys through a different agent, or they didn't really, you know, you didn't feel appreciated because there was really zero contact after that. They just went away, went somewhere else. That's fine too. You're not going to win them all. Okay, you're just not going to win them all. It's okay if someone does this to you. This is part of the business that you guys got to understand. Okay, the point is maybe you want to do this across 5 or 10 for sale by owners and kind of see what happens. You're going to get 6 or 7 out of the 10 that do future business with you for the rest of their life. Okay, like I said from the beginning, if I would have known this from day one, I would have been doing deals within my first month using this strategy. You need momentum in not transactions and not business and not money. You need momentum in relationships in the business to get to the money. The more relationships you have, the more transactions you're going to have, period. So I'm really looking forward to putting this strategy in action Thursday. Click subscribe, hit the bell so you can get notified when I go live there. I'm going to be calling for sell by owners, and I'm going to go through this process live for you to watch. So tune in, shoot me some comments. I'll be answering questions and all that good stuff. I've really been enjoying the process of helping you guys. You guys are motivating me every single day, every single message I get from you. It's motivated me not only to push harder in the coaching world and help more and more agents, but it's also elevating my real estate game. So I thank you for that. And if there's anything in the world I could do for you, reach out. We'll talk to you guys soon.